Hi, welcome to an Onshape video tutorial. I want to do the fan impeller in Onshape. Not as easy as in the other programs because there's still some commands missing in this program, but it looks pretty good. So let's have fun with Onshape. Okay. Let's start with the sketch, maybe on the front plane. View normal to the sketch plane, and this could look something like this. I need an arc. Let's go for a 3-point arc. 1, 2, and yes, then another line. Okay, now let's make this vertical. This should be vertical and tangency. I snapped the tangency. Now give it some dimensions. This would be 5. This would be 80. This would be 75. Really? So back, maybe. Move this a little bit over here. That's not possible. Try to move that. Yeah, that's more like it. Now give that a dimension. That would be 75. Then add this dimension or change it to 75. This looks better. And I need coincidence between that point and this point. And seems it didn't snap on the tangency. Let's check. This one and that one should be tangent. Okay, so what's missing? Okay, of course, I forgot that dimension from that point to that line, and that would be 100. Okay, close that sketch. Make a revolve with that sketch, and the axis would be that line. And confirm. Now let's make a shell. So go for maybe hide that one. Go for shell. This face should be removed. That one. And the wall should have a thickness of 5. And confirm. Now I need an offset plane. So go for a plane. Should be offset from the top. And the offset should be 80. Okay. Now let's do a sketch on that plane. View normal to sketch plane. And these should be two lines or a rectangle. You could do with a rectangle as well. And that should be 35 by, I don't know. So let's make it symmetric. This line, that line should be symmetric to that plane. And this line and that line should be symmetric to that plane. Now the distance, therefore I need a circle because I don't want to use the edges, and make it like this, then make it for construction only. Okay, change the diameter to 140, and I could hide that body for the moment, so it's easier to draw. Now I need a line which starts on that line and goes to that circle. It should be, yeah, it's okay. This line should be for construction only. And add a dimension. That dimension would be 45. And let's move this line over here and give it another dimension. From that point to that line, it should be 7.5 millimeter. Close that sketch, show that part, and I want to make an extrude with a new body, new, and I want to extrude that sketch, but not blind, but up to face. That would be this face, and okay, height, it should be a new part, no, not add, it jumped to add, sorry, okay, now it's a new part, height, that part for the moment, another sketch on that plane. View normal to that sketch plane and that could be another rectangle. Again, make it symmetric. This line, that line, two. It's a little bit slow today, really. To this one, and again that line, and that line to that plane. Add dimensions 1, 2, and this would be 25, and that distance doesn't really matter. Maybe I go for 80. Now, these two lines should be for construction only. This one and that one. Now, leave that sketch and make a rip. Go for rip. Not these edges, but this edge and that edge. Extend profiles to part, yes. The part would be this one, and it shouldn't be parallel to the sketch plane, but normal to the sketch plane, and turn it around. Okay, and thickness should be 10. And confirm. Now I can remove that part from the other part by a Boolean operation. Just show it. Go for Boolean. Subtract. Tool would be this body. Target would be that body right here. And confirm. Now add some chamfers. Chamfer, that would be 5, equal distance, yes. On this edge, this one, and that one. And confirm. Now I need another sketch. On that plane. You know what a sketch plan? I need a circle. Diameter would be 40. Then another rectangle. Make it symmetric. This line, that line to that plane, this line to that plane. Nope, it's really odd today. Very slow. Select, it should be orange. Select, select. Now it's okay. Add dimensions. That distance would be 60, and this distance should be 15. Now trim. This, that one, this one, that one. Stop the sketch and make an extrude. Make it a remove. Make it up to through all. And that would be this sketch. And turn it around. And okay. Very nice. Now to the tricky part. I couldn't find an option to make a projection, to project a curve onto a face. If there is one, I cannot find it. So what I want to do is draw a curve, make an extrude, and split that surface and use the edges of that surface as path for my sweep. Okay, now let's hide that part. And I need a sketch on the front plane. And this sketch looks something like this. And then I need an arc. Let's see if I got the tangency. I should have tangency, so align that point and this point, and make an angle between that plane and that line. This would be 85, okay, that distance would be 105, and that radius would be 30. Then add some lines just for construction. Make these two for construction. Add that constraint. Oh, nice. And what's missing? Okay, I need a point on that line. That point should be also coincident to that plane, and the distance from that point to this point should be 100. And I got my sketch. Confirm that sketch. Show that part. So I want to make an extrude with that sketch, but it's a face. So go for extrude, a surface, with that sketch right here. And in that direction, so make it maybe, doesn't really matter, 100. At least it should be visible. Now, let's see if I can split with that surface. If not, I have to make a new surface. Let's see if that's possible. I don't know. Let's check it out. Where's split? That's split. I want to split that surface with that body. See, that's not possible. Or is it possible? No, it's not possible. So I need a surface. Therefore, I will use my first sketch, that sketch, and make a revolve and make a surface. So go for another revolve. Axis would be the same as before. So make it visible. That would be the axis. And I need a surface. That's kind of crazy. With that curve, and it should not be full but maybe symmetric, let's say 90 degrees. So that's sort of on the wrong side, so I need more. Maybe not symmetric, so let's go one direction better. So let's go for 180. Why not? Okay, now I could split that surface with this surface. So go for split. I want to split that surface with this surface. Okay, so select that one and then select this one. Seems I got only one, so add this as well. Really go for face, because part should select all of this, but it doesn't. So go for face, 1, 2. Okay. So it's really slow today. Let's try once again and hide that body. Maybe it's easier to select. Okay, now. And I have to split that surface with a plane which should be 5 up. So let's do a plane with an offset to that one. and the offset would be 5 millimeter. And let's split that surface with this plane first. So go for split. I want to split that one with this plane. And confirm. Now I could hide that surface, this one, it's really so slow. Okay, fine. Now split that surface with this surface, so go for another split. I want to split, not mirror, split that face with this face, and okay, now I could hide that part, should be surface 3, yes. Now I want to make a combined curve from that edges, so go for a composite curve, this edge, that one, come on, and this one. Confirm and hide that surface. Maybe show that body. Okay, now I need another sketch on that plane, which is 5 millimeter above that top plane. So go for a sketch on this one. And maybe hide that body, and I need one point in my sketch, I have to project it, so just go for use that point right here, then do a line from that center point to that point. Maybe view normal to sketch plane. And this should be for construction. And I need another line, which starts, let's make it like this. Make it back to normal. And this should be not 55 but 56. So let's add that dimension, that would be 56. Why not 55 as in the other programs? Because this has to be a little bit on the inside, so it intersects with the part, otherwise I could not combine the bodies afterwards. So let's see, make them parallel, this one, that one, nice. Now put that point onto that line. Let's move this up a little bit, at least try, okay, and give it another dimension, and that would be from this point to that point. And this should be 0.5 from that point to this point, and it should be aligned. That's not possible. Zoom in a little bit like this, and that should be 1 millimeter. So it's it intersects with the body right here. Okay, leave that sketch. Let's take a look. Now I need a sweep, and I want to do surfaces, and I want to sweep that line along that path, and maybe like this, or you could use the composite curve. And keep profile orientation, no, that's okay. Now let's thicken this. So thicken, make it a new body, yes. I want to thicken that surface. So that would be that sweep. Make it 1 millimeter in both directions. I'm making a new body, or yes, a new body. 1 millimeter, 1 millimeter, yes, and confirm. Now let's add some fillets, 20 millimeter. Select that edge and this edge. Confirm. Now let's make a pattern. A circular pattern, and I want to pattern parts, that's okay, part pattern, this part, and the axis of that would be the axis of that cylinder, and I want to have 12 instances, equal spacing, and confirm. And now finally I have to make a union. So go for Boolean, Union, and just select all of them. And confirm. And hide all planes. And I'm done, and maybe hide all the sketches as well. So where's the sketch? Well, let's hide all sketches. Okay. So hope you enjoyed this one. If you liked it, please give it a like. If you want to see more, give it a like. Please, please subscribe to my Facebook Cat fan page and like it, please. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thanks for watching. See you to the next one. Bye bye.